Everyone, and welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing well. Hope you're having a much better day and a nice day, even or much fun. Because today we're doing final video before the artwork of Nomophila, and it's their newest song, like literally uploaded yesterday. It's gonna be really, really cool because it's their newest song at all, like at this time period that we are at. Anyone watching after, maybe they have new songs. But I get to see their most recent, let's say, music composition, choice of lyrics. I think, do we have subtitles? Yes! Ooh, nice. Okay. Now this is gonna be cool. The song is called Adabanam. I don't know if I said it right. It sounds interesting. I don't know what it could mean. But I guess maybe we'll find out. I am expecting crazy vocals. A solo duet of guitars, a killer bass that just fills the depth the song needs, and a crazy guitar and drum solo, and occasional nice break music. When there's maybe some a cappella vocals? I don't know, that's the things I love that they do usually. So, let's see. Maybe they've completely changed for this one. Maybe they wanted something completely different. Let's get surprised! Wow, okay. Let's talk about it until now because it's crazy. First of all, I like how the pace is slower than the ones we've seen until now. I like how we get a bit of a different pace. Like, it's not their super fast song that I've seen the last two songs at least. I also really like their cuts, like when they're hitting the music. I love their outfits. They're so cool. They also really nicely coordinate with each other. There's a nice like editing and setup. Like, there's smoke around them, which is really, really cool and interesting. And I just really, really like it. I feel like drums don't keep actual rhythm. They're just part of a nice beat of the song. It's not like just keeping the rhythm. Like, I feel it super incorporated, which is really nice. There's a nice beat with guitars and a nice little riff and that's going on. Really nice. Of course, Mayu just goes off and add to killer vocals, which is really, really interesting. I don't know, I like it. It's a nice combination. It gave me chills the first time Mayu hit her crazy killer vocals. But from there on, I've been really nice and chill because I got the mood of the song straight away. And I'm just like living through it right now. It's really nice. I also love the little distortion. What exactly is that with the guitar sound? It's really nice. It's really interesting. It's kind of a fade of the music there. It's really cool. It adds a mysterious vibe, I think, to the whole song, which is nice because they're not aggressive when they're going slower. I like how they're like methodically creating a mysterious, tense atmosphere. It's not even tense. It's really nice and relaxing, but you're getting like the vibe that something's gonna happen. Which is really, really cool because it just builds up tension.
Oh.
Okay, what's really, really, really cool is I actually love how they just went into that chorus, into that verse. So it's such an interesting way, as if like music stayed slow and nice and steady, and then like vocals just went quicker and a bit of a rap kind of vibe. It's so interesting how she did it. And I love how the music afterwards quickened as well. And I love how after we have this whoa, it just calms down again. And it's gonna build up again, which is, I like it. It's a nice roller coaster vibe. I like the build up here. And it's also nice because she goes a bit off, let's say the tempo they do. She goes completely like the opposite count. Like you would do 1, 2, 1, 2, she's going 1, 2, 1, 2. It's basically the opposite, but yeah. And then she hits us with this, which goes completely off. And I like it. It's really nice because it keeps the attention going since she did something a bit irregular. Also hits high notes here, which she hasn't yet. It's the first time we hit high notes, which is very satisfying and very fulfilling. Okay, this music break is everything. I love how they are going full off now with the beat and the sound and the speed. So fulfilling. I also want to question, are these nemophilas that they have in the background there with the like the transparency double thing? They look like nemophilas, but I'm not sure. But they look really, really cool. And it could be, which is like a nice reference too. Oh my god, guitar distortions here and the discs from the drums. So satisfying to hear right after like a quick pace music part. Okay, I'm guessing we're going for solos. What I love is how smoothly they went into this. I love it. They're giving us a mysterious vibe first guitar. I like this. I was like building up. They just smoothly brought it down and started the guitar solos. It's so fun. It's so different. I like it so much. They did it so smoothly, especially after the smooth like transition there as well with the high notes. Wow. It's also super mysterious. Like, it continues. All that at the end, gorgeous. Can we talk about the fact that we had a bit of a Tamu solo? That was so much fun, drum solo a bit at the end before like going back into a bit of a music break, and right after going back in for the actual guitar solo duet, which was really quick. It was like solo 2 seconds, solo 2 seconds, combining them. It was so fun. Oh my god, that drum session there. So much fun, because it had discs, it had drums. It wasn't like the regular like fast pace. It was like cutting in between. It was so interesting, truly. And how we got back into the song too, like, oof. And also guitar. I love that. That was so much. It was so iconic. I was like, oh, I see. Ah, this is so much fun, bro. Saki and Hazuki together are insane. Like, they are the duo that's like, they are so connected, and they just make things happen so much fun, like, and entertaining on stage. You just can't ignore. It's so cool. I also just love how you could hear the bass in the background just being so nice and deep. It just fulfills like that empty space. Before this build up, like, you could hear a nice deepness, and then like there's an intensity building up here, and then it's even more deep again. I love this party. It's just so playful and fun. You're like, come on. You're just showing off at this point. It's so much fun. God, like, and the point that they reach here, you're like, you've just created a masterpiece, because they just circle back into this, and I am so invested that I'm like, oh yes, we're going back into this, and I know which part of this is, and it's gorgeous and perfect and like, whew, crazy to hear. Oh my god, amazing. Okay, can we talk about the lyrics? They're so cool. I love how we reference the flower, because their whole band name is referenced to flower. Their logo is referenced to flower. It's so pretty. Probably the image is the flower that we're talking about. Is the flower that I'm off of the flower. I love how they did this. I love how we just hit it and we just went with it. The lyrics are so powerful, and like, they are empowering as well. Like, they're like, show yourself and how powerful and like strong you are to the ones who bullied you, because you're beautiful. We were born beautiful. It's so nice. Wow. I just saw the reference to the flower. I'm like, oof, wow. Like, wow, our life is like a flower. I like that. I like that reference. The beauty of a flower, the lifetime of a flower, how important our life is due to that. It's so nice. Wow. It's very insightful. You're like very it's just like a nice piece of advice and a beautiful song. I also love the break we had there where Hazuki did just a little bit of a guitar with the whole team breaking up the music and then started again. That was so nice. Got this rhythm too, like do 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 do. They just got this rhythm down and they got me addicted to it. It's so nice. Oh, I think it's here. Look at this pause. It's completely no music, just vocals. Completely got an a cappella part going. And now we get a bit of a guitar solo just to break up the whole thing after this huge impact of music, which is perfect. Amazing. Like, oh my God. And that ending is just beautiful. I love them. They are insane. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Check out Saturday for the artwork video. Wow. Like, this song is beyond. It goes beyond everything and it's insane. I really hope like we get to see more stuff from them because they've got a thing going that's really good, and they've got the motivation and the power. I like their lyrics. I like their playfulness in the music. I like how they nicely break from like the very intense music to nice a cappella parts that's even at some point, which is really cool since they're a band. But for a few seconds just to hear the voice and then the whole music just kicks in when you're a whole band is so different and so special that I absolutely love it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to like, subscribe, click the bell for notifications. I'll put it over sending you. Check out Patreon so you get sneak peeks before everyone else, and also to be able to suggest and vote for the next artist. So for now, bye bye.